Wait, so am I really quiet again? Sorry, wrong knob. All right, turn the correct knob. Sorry. So what I was saying is, Eternicus, hello, Silver. So Hikaru JPM made the livery I'm about to drive, so I have to at least put it on the track once or twice, right? So what I was saying, Eternicus, is that it's a big American car. Also, hi. And hi, Rizzo. It's a big American car, and what it needs is a bunch of Germans to come through and just make it efficient. That's what it needs. And then, hey Risen, and then hand it off to the Japanese to fine-tune it. And then it would be the perfect car. So let the Americans build the base. Then the Germans come through and go, no. And then they fix it up. And then the Japanese are like, yeah, we can make it even better. And oh, we made it fast. Durr. So that's my call. So if someone can just get on that. That would be great. And the game knows. It puts me right back. Hey, Jonicus. Hey, App. Wow. I can't even try to say your name. BC. Your name is BC. I mean, you were on there probably for several hours, right? So, I don't know many of these people, so we're not going to talk. We're not talking to anyone right now. Yeah, exactly. Actually, I heard from a friend of a friend that the 86 actually was the Viper originally. 5 hours of lawn mowing. You went to the beach? Nice. Okay. So, even though Hikaru JP is probably not here, I'm going to run a race in the Viper and see where we go from there. So there it is. Oops. Where's the button? There it is. The car. For Eternicus. On the back. Eternicus, read the back. It says, for you. For the Eternicus. That's what I meant to show you. And that's why we're driving it. Properly. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. No. Okay, there we go. This thing does not turn. Jesus. Ah, it's like driving a brick. The car. I'm just a danger to myself and everyone around me. Go, hey guy, go. I can't drive this car. Have a good race. Fast on this race. And the pull is amazing. Like 250 across that is fast. I just don't know how to make it stop. I don't know how to stop it. And then it won't turn. It's 7 hours of lawn mowing. Lawn mowing, that's insane. Good one, Silver. Oh, that's good. That's why they call them muscles, muscle cars. It's like a boat. Jesus Christ. I'm not gonna fight you. I'm not gonna fight you. I'm not gonna fight you. Well, I am now, though. I'm gonna be a jerk. You have to earn the position now. I was just gonna give it to you, but no. Hey, Space Laser. Struggling in the Viper. Whew. very difficult car to drive. See ya.
Lurking is Arian Silva. Space laser.
Yeah, that's... I can't drive that. Alright, I'm gonna have to give up. I don't know how people drive that car. Car JPM made delivery. So... So, I took it out for a drive, and I need to show Eternicus the back of the car. All right, that's it. I'm done. sorry, Viper. Yeah, you look good. Look purdy. Look super purdy. So what I said earlier, Laser, was, by the way, pew, pew, pew. I definitely got you that time. The Viper would benefit from some German engineering and then some Japanese engineering afterward to just clean up the mess that is the Viper. Or PD could have just not nerfed it into the ground. That would have been the better solution.
Space laser
from K-Tail. Isn't it K-Tail? It was K-Tail, right? Are they still around? Is K-Tail still a thing? With the Ion Disruptor Beam. Batteries not included. Beautiful car, though. Beautiful livery. Absolutely love it. Can't drive it. Sorry. K-Tail. Wait, am I that old? I mean, Risen has to know K-Tail. Come on, you guys. Don't tell me I'm that old. Please. You're from Hasbro. K-Tail was just the... So Siri knows. Siri knows, but hold on. We have the car. Go to the track. So K-Tail was, K-Tail... Sorry, hold on. It was like early infomercial TV shopping kind of thing, I believe. Headquartered in... So, products are television advertising and music. It's still going. Headquartered in Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. It's still going. New site coming soon. Oh, so music licensing, mini pop kids. So they've got pure music, huh? So yeah, back to... Oh shoot, I am not concentrating on what I should be doing here. Okay. So K-Tail's based in Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, and has been in business since the late 1960s. It has subsidiaries, blah, 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 blah. Yada, yada, yada. K-Tail was founded by Philip Keeves? Kives? Kives. Keeves? Blah, 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 blah. From Saskatchewan. Blah, 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 blah. So back in Canada. So he tried some door-to-door sales stuff. Cookware door-to-door. Pitchman on boardwalk in Atlantic City. Blah, 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 blah. Back in Canada in 1962, he used his own money and his fast-talking demonstration style to create a new kind of television advertisement. His first product was a Teflon-coated frying pan. Yes! He made a deal with Eaton's department store to carry the product and the local television station to air the commercials on a per-inquiry basis with a guaranteed minimum. He bought and marketed a number of products from Seymour Popel, father of Ronco founder Ron Pump, I can't pronounce his name, including the Dial-O-Matic and the Vegematic food slicers, the Feather Touch Knife. In August 1965, he began selling the Feather Touch Knife, Australia, and by Christmas had... something's odd here. Okay, grammar error. Later began sourcing his own products, including the Miracle Brush, which sold 28 million units of the Miracle Brush. Okay. Popeil, is that it? So, the Miracle Brush. K-Tel was formally incorporated in 1968 with something else, blah, 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 blah. So, in 5 years prior to 1981, K-Tel sold more than $150 million in LPs in 34 countries. The company diversified. Check this out. The company diversified, forming subsidiaries in areas such as real estate and oil exploration. And also acquired rival Candlelight Records in 1980. K-Tel lost $15.9 million, I'm going to assume US dollars, when Candlelight customers refused to pay for their shipments. The failure of this and several other high-risk ventures resulted in the publicly traded U.S. entity K-Tel International filing for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection in 1984. Foreclosed, blah blah. And then he 6 years later, after legal battles, guy got his company back. So yeah, it stops at 1993. So that's K-Tel, the Miracle Brush. And that's the old... Oh man, that's the old... Dan Aykroyd bit on Saturday Night Live about the Fish-O-Matic or something. It's a riff off of the K-Tel fast-talking advertisement style. You get racing. At iMorph TV, you get racing. You get American history. You get space lasers with ion disruptor beams. Disruption beams. Disruptor beams, what do we settle on? You get it all here. That is the history of K-Tel. Oh, God. Oh, you've added some stuff to the playlist? Excellent. Actually, I'm going to listen to it on my way to work tomorrow. Oh, dear Lord. Ion disruptor beam. Okay. Oh, I was trying to eat quietly. I had some pork flavored, I don't know, it's kind of like miso soup but with lots of pork. And I just ate, had some yogurt and some protein, and probably have maybe some, I'm not sure what she's whipping up, but Mrs. Imore TV is whipping up something. Alright, car is set up properly, I believe. We had four in the front. I don't know why I had it set that far, but I guess it was drivable. So that TCS turned down to one. Look at the SS driver. Look at that one SS driver with a 324. What is he doing? Why is he there? Ooh. What we're grilling. All right. So, I can't, sorry, you can hear me moving around, right? I'm having a fashion malfunction. Sorry. Okay. So I came in here thinking I'm going to win one more tonight before, you know, the reset. But seeing where I'm starting, my hopes are not high. Oh, why am I doing that? Don't! What am I doing? You idiot. Don't do that. Okay, so what did I decide on? I was going to see how things... I'm in back. Who cares? I'm going to start saving fuel from behind. Why not? Yep. And beer. Hamburgers, hot dogs. You can't brew beer. Well, you do brew beer, but you can't barbecue beer. Oh, shoot. Shoot. Car just snapped. I think that's only half a second. There were people behind me. You know, first race, always a little rough. First race of the evening. Oh. Along. Lag isn't crazy like it was last night. Lag was off.
Look, it was insane.
Sunday afternoon, Sunday evening, driving a fast car by myself. I think at least three of those guys ahead of me are going to pit. I hope they decide to pit, or I'll have them forward. Oops. And the guy behind pitted. As a penalty. Sweet. Pulling away from home. Unless I'm that slow. He took his penalty and still pulled ahead. Jesus. I just dropped it out. time so I can push at the end and catch up. Hit though, a lot easier. If I just pit, make my life simpler, that'd be great. Oh, Come on, Will. Turn. Well, that's it. Not gonna work. Done. All that. Thank you. He ran out of gas. Sweet. Sweet.
Wow.
Yeah. Yes. Month, man. I'm gonna pat myself on the back. Well, no, I can't take credit for that. The turn was that Porsche curve, and before you hit the main straight, that's some of that is Microat Brazil turnstile, the turn one, Interlagos. Some of it is Thunderface talking about shifting the weight of the car. Some of it is Focusrite about trying to get grip to the front of the car to turn. There's all the things that you guys have said over the months. Someone talked about like using the gee, thanks Obama, using like dropping down a few gears to force the car to brake a bit more. So you can get the turn, you know, you want to get into a lower gear. I don't know if it's lower or higher. So from third to second, instead of going through in third, go through in second. That's what it forces the car to turn in a little bit, right? I think. And so, yeah, all the things that you guys have said over the months, I try to apply them to the best of my ability. And the result is DRB for a month. You guys want to run lobbies? You guys decide, see how many of you are ready to race lobbies. If not, I will run one more. Set that up actually. So I need to step away. I will go to this screen, and if you guys are ready to run lobbies, then I will back out and we can run lobbies. I shall return momentarily. All right. Hey, Eternicus. Pizza rolls, watching Germany versus Japan. That's really a tough one for me, Eternicus. So we believe we are Dutch or German ancestry. But I'm here in Japan, so I'm going to pull for volleyball. I'm rooting for volleyball. That's what I'm going to go with here. Go volleyball! It is volleyball. Or is it handball? Is it handball? Volleyball. Okay. Bad daughter enjoys, actually we all do, enjoy watching volleyball. So whenever there are like really huge international events, we get a text from bad daughter like, hey, could you guys record blah blah blah, and oh, it's on, make sure you record it. We get frantic texts like that. Excuse me. So yes, yeah, we really enjoy it. That SS, that attic light, man, so suspicious. Also, is Laser still here? I should ask if she's watching the volleyball. See if she's watching volleyball. I'm not gonna go walk into her room and ask her. No. I'm gonna text her. She's only in the next room, but modern technology allows. You only have the saber, the Zauber. Saber. Jesus Christ. The Zauber for. Wow. The Zauber for, GR1. How's it going? Text message has been sent. And she's probably ignoring me.
That's cool.
So, I think the trick is I can't run fuel map two at the start. I've actually got to gamble on fuel. Thank you. well, the situation has changed. I think I can get away with that through map 2 here at the start. Is he saving fuel? Is that his thing, what he's doing? Position. not possible. It's only lap two. Maybe his mom called him.
He was gay. Hola. Come on, you got a nice day.
Sorry, I'm cracking myself up. I'm sorry.
Shoot. Probably too much fuel again. Slightly vulnerable. Gonna have to ease around this lap. They're gonna chase me down. Spot here. Save a little more fuel. Thank you. sucks to be him. And there's the car a little bit longer. he barely made it across the line. We both screwed up. Ah, if I had just been a bit closer. Well, moved up 4 positions. I'll take it. Should have had 11 had I come out of that chicane properly, but didn't crash. Better than nothing. Thank you. Thanks, iTurf. Thank you, Tourniquets. Man. LM55 is faster than I thought. Thank you, Risen. Taco Bell boy. What a great name. That's a friend request I received. Hello, Taco Bell boy. Sorry, Taco Bell boys. 305. Okay.
I get a car.
Oh, new Fugazi, please. Another Fugazi. 2. Stop! No, no. Ah. Who's doing what? Big bucks, no whammies. I don't know what that is, but yes. We want big bucks and we do not need your whammies. Get your whammies out of here. And your whacked pajamas. How's that? Your luck. Okay, all right. I'm gonna try one more. Maybe I just need to change the car. No. Don't change a horse in midstream. I'm familiar with SRT. I don't know if I can drive the LM55. I don't crash when I drive the Tomahawk. Well, I do crash, but it's not as frequent as when I drive some of the other vehicles. So I'm gonna stick with the SRT, because it's safe. What is that line from? Never change a horse in midstream. What? Is that from Groundhog? Groundhog Day? Never change a horse in midstream. Never change a horse in midstream. What's that from? Never change up mid-stride? Was that it? What movie is that from? Hey, the Lanatron. Oh my goodness, hello, Lanatron. How are you, Mr. Fast? Mr. or Mrs. Fast? It is the Lanatron from the GTS Racing League. Yep, we're doing well. How's the league going, Lanatron? So next week's race is Goodwood, Suzuka. Is it Sardinia? It's not Degna. That would just be too weird. Sardinia, I'm going to go with, until someone corrects me. One make. So we received some new cars, right? So, the Toyota truck, that's it. Group X. Well, the truck is not in Group X. Which league are you running in? All right, I'm starting off in 8th. Okay, so now I'm with my people. We have Ghost King AU, Twin Turbo Moto. That's not the same guy. So Pure Pine, ST12, Duchin, whoever that is. So these are all the people I'm familiar with. 10th, 11th, and 12th. 6th and 7th. And yeah. The Fast Boys up front. No idea. I'm trying to sneak in one more win, Lanatron, before the week ends. Oh, I can't remember, maybe 2 or 3 days ago, started quite similarly, maybe 6th or 7th, and I think 1st, 2nd, and 3rd all crashed out, right? And then the guy who was in 3rd he would pass me and then screw up, and something happened. Yes, please, yes, yes. The more the merrier. The more people we have here, the merrier, the more luck. Also, a very important question. Are you a coffee drinker, a fancy coffee drinker, a beer drinker, and a breakfast, or a breakfast beer drinker, or the newly created breakfast cereal club? So we have breakfast cereal club, breakfast beer, fancy coffee club. You can be a member of one or all three. It's up to you. Fancy coffee. Excellent. Welcome to the team. All right. Hype. Yep, hype. Gotta get into it. I need beer or fancy coffee. Rizzo. We've also started a breakfast cereal club. It was sort of a fluke, but I'm running with it. I'm running with the breakfast cereal club or spiked coffee or the spiked coffee club. Yes. All right, so I'm starting at 8th. I can't screw around on fuel. I've got to push I hope Ghost King is in here. I've got to push Ghost King to burn up a lot of fuel. So that's, I can at least pick up 7. Twin Turbo Moto occasionally crashes. Good on fuel. Pure Pine crashes a lot. I'm not worried about Pure Pine. Either gonna crash or run out of gas or hit someone. right on the edge here of fuel. Just a little extra. Very difficult to move from back here. 22 seconds ahead. Carnage up ahead, folks. Front runner carnage, great right about now. And there goes Pure Pine. Oof. Couldn't see him. Knew he was there. Gave him space. That could have been a disaster. Thank you. Yes! Yes! Oh, thank you. Yes! Yes! I called it, right? I told you. That twin guy crashes. Pine always crashes. Yes. When you know your competition. Oh. Hey, ESP. Welcome back, Space Laser. I can't shout because it's 11 o'clock at night. My neighbors will get angry. Yes. Whew. Hey, Scuds. Oh, man. So I had to let those... You know how difficult it is, right? Because you want to finish in front of the other guy. When, I can't remember if it was Pure Pine or Twin Guy that made the pass on me. I'm like, you know what? Just let it go. Let it go. Let it go. It's okay. It's all going to work out. You gotta trust that it's going to work out. And when I saw them, I forget which corner, but I could see them like, oh, they've gone wide. Oh, they've missed a breaking point. Oh, 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 into the gravel, into the sand trap. Bye. All right, it's 11 o'clock. Should I gamble and run one more? I'm really tired, you guys. I mean, we're on a high, right? Three places. Not clean race. Three places. ESP, you're either going to crash a lot or spend a lot of time going, wait, how do I go fast again? I think the number one thing that you're going to notice is cars that you previously, if you had to run traction control, you can dial it down one or two notches right off the bat. Right off the bat, you can dial it down one or two notches because with the controller, you need traction control. But with the wheel, the need is not so much, you don't need it as much. So if you were running TCS 3, try 2 or 1. Yeah. If you're at 1, maybe gamble for 0. I got nothing there. But if you're running like TCS3 for turbocharged cars, you might drop that down to 2 and get a little more speed. So 0, 1, or 2. Okay, so things that were 0 aren't going to be as challenging, it won't be as difficult. 2 you can drop to 1, 1 you might be able to drop to 0. I think your brake bias is going to change. So not only are you going to drive differently, how you set the car up is going to be slightly different. So play around with that. If you used to drive with a more rear bias, you might want to move it forward a little bit. You just play around with all that good stuff, yeah? But it takes time. All right, so, and then you can ask the fast guys here. Scuds is here, Lanatron is here. I know there's some other people that run with wheels that might be lurking. McCroyd is not lurking today, so. Water Heater is here, he has a wheel. I'm quite sure they can pass on some good information. I'm a total noob. So, from a noob perspective, that was me. From the Fast Boys, you might get something else. All right, I'm going to run one more, and then I'm going to bed. I think this is going to be the final one. Whew. A lot. Yeah. Yeah. You want to go? It's like, yeah, I got a wheel. I'm going to be fast. It's like, what's with the wall? Who put that wall there? That sand trap, was it? Has that always been there? Yeah. There's that word again. Ugh. Oh, that word. Ugh. Ugh. We're talking about practice? We're talking about practice? See, man after my own heart. Oh my God. So Laser, I just saw the interior. Oh my God. I love you guys so much. Not a game, not a game, not a game. All right, this is the final one of the evening, you guys. No matter what. This is the final game of the evening. Final race of the evening.
That could be a total lie. Could be a total lie.
There he is. We talk about... See, everyone knows me so well. We talk about practice. I related this whole situation to my dad, and he just, every now and again when I talk about my exploits here and activities in Gran Turismo Sport, he would just hit me with a,
talking about practice.
Excellent. Oh man, I feel so good. I feel so honored, Laser. All right, you guys, the other big news is that I've managed to remain in the top 10 on my own friend rankings board. You know how rare this is? And that's with Psydog, Monkey Man, and Hikaru JPN, and Ethan, all the fast boys.
Yes, yes, I'm so happy.
Hello, Mr. Sleepyhead. All right, the game is just... Because you're still asleep. ESP, you're in the U.S., correct? Okay, so now I don't know any of these people. I don't know how they're going to behave during the race. It's a pure and total mystery. EU server, so Eternicus is in the EU. I'm not sure about the Lanatron. I am not sure about the Lanatron. Who else is Eternicus? Erky is in the U.S. I'm not sure about Scuds. I don't know which region Scuds races in. It's either U.S. or Europe. It's only remaining two, right? You guys should totally get a roll 20 table set up. Designate a time, even if it's just talking about old. You hate being medication sober. What is that? Now. Is it totally off the table for the time being? I'm going to hold multiple conversations. You've played on Roll 20 before? So, Risen, I think Gotham's Guts has played on Roll 20 before. He runs a game. You guys should just at least hop on like 20 minutes and have a chat. Just, you know, just to get it going, right? You don't have to go and have a full-fledged, what do you guys call them? What do they call it in D&D? I've never played D&D but once, but after that I was uninvited. Campaign. Don't try to play a whole campaign. Just... Okay. All right. But eventually you will be able to. And I understand medication sober. I really like that laser. I know it's not... You know what I mean by I love it. It's a great phrasing. So can people just sit in and not participate? Like, could Risen just sit and listen? All right. I don't know how to play this one. I think until the main straight, I'm just going to run it on one. That's gonna give me a half a second penalty for sure. Shoot. Get him! Catch him! Catch him, Laser! Catch him! Everyone, catch McCroat! Quick, don't let him escape! Poutine, whatever that stuff is called, and beer. Lost him already, haven't we? Oof. Man, those cones are dangerous. All right, so here we come to the lap where we find out who's gonna pit. The guy behind me is gonna pit. The guys up ahead are gonna pit. I need people to pit. I need them to cooperate with my strategy. See how it goes. Well, I'm screwed. No one's pitting. Dang it! Oh, that guy did. And he's carrying a penalty. Awesome. That could have been a catastrophe. That could have been ugly. Alright, well, no one ahead is pitting. This guy is checking out. I handed him the position. So now, all we can hope for, people miscalculated their fuel loads, or crash. Shoot. Apparently he was also saving fuel. Don't know if I'm gonna catch him. That man's checking out. Dang it. Dang it. This guy is fast. He outsmarted me. I thought I was gonna get him. You know, but he was running at his max fuel. Six must be running out of gas. He's running out of fuel. I'm not gonna make it. I'm not gonna catch him in time. Oh, whoever's in six, they just coasted across the start finish line. Ah. All right. Hey, Regis. Tips for saving fuel. Short shift. Try to get the draft. All right, I still moved up one position. I'll take it. All right, you guys, that's it. Arms are exhausted. Thank you, Space Laser. I don't want the week to end. I don't want the new week to begin. If we could just have Group 1 at Sarth all the time, that would be great. I'd be really happy with that. $3.32, that's not bad. I have work in the morning, which means I can't stay up too late. All right, that's it. The week is over. I've managed to score one win. Right, managed to score one win. I think a top five. So, in general, my basic fear of Sarth is gone. I've come to grips with my fear of Group 1. So, we're gonna call it a week. Yeah, I've got work tomorrow. I've gotta travel all the way across town. It's hot, I'm gonna be dehydrated. I'm going to be an adult. Yes, yes. Hey, Dr. Duck, I'm just wrapping up. I've decided to be an adult instead of streaming until 1 a.m. I'm going to stop it here. And yes, I do, Regis. You're welcome, Risen. Hopefully you enjoy your grilling. You have some beverage. Melimony! It's Melimony! Hello, Mel. You're welcome, Scuds. Yeah, I think I'd call it a pretty good week, too. That win here, really, really... Whew. Hey, thanks for joining Rijisakira.
Malimini.
Everyone hearts to Malimini.
Hello, Mel.
Haven't seen you in a while. She's also a member of the Fantasy Coffee Club. And for those that don't know, we have a mug. There is a mug for those of you who enjoy your coffee fancy. I believe Lanatron mentioned that they enjoy their coffee fancy. All right. Fancy cold brew. Nice. See ya, Akira. With a name like Akira, are you here also in Japan? Nope. Nope. We don't have a dinner cereal club. You can you can join the breakfast cereal club, which means you can eat it any time. So the nice thing about breakfast cereal club is that breakfast cereal can be eaten for any meal. That's FCC and BCC. And then the breakfast cereal club is an up and coming for those that enjoy breakfast cereal at lunch, at breakfast, at dinner. I cannot partake of this. And exactly. We are worldwide. Somewhere, there's always time for breakfast. Because it's like, sign me up. There you go. All right, we got everyone covered. All right, we all know what time it is. Raisin bran for dinner. Winning. Nope, wrong thing. Space laser. You know the drill. I will see everyone tomorrow. Have the rest of your Sunday. I think it's Sunday morning for some of you. Thank you, Mel. And I will see you tomorrow. Space laser, take it away. Space laser. The only laser. Mikroat escaped us again, didn't he? Doggone it. Mikroat, and always Ghost is probably here too. Both of them. Master lurkers. Be on the lookout. See you, Gotons. Bye, Scuds. Mel. Eternicus. I hope you enjoyed your day at the beach the other day. ESP, thank you. Get luck adjusting to your wheel before the music gets too loud. To everyone I miss, if you're here, kind of JPN, quite possibly Erky was here earlier. Kaz, I think, was lurking. And to everyone else, I love you and I will see you tomorrow.